American troops leave home again. The story at 10.
I had that dream again.
The sex one with the volunteer fireman?
No. And that was not a sex dream. The hose represented cleansing.
Whatever.
No, this was the school dream where somehow I'm back in high school. I'm sitting in my class in my underwear when I realize that not only did I not study for the test, I haven't been to class all year.
Whew. Man, I know that feeling.
Really? Well, I guess everybody's had that dream.
Dream?
Wants you to share in the magic of Walt Disney's newest video classic, Beauty and the Beast. Now your kids can collect Beast, Belle, Chip, and Cogsworth. Each puppet's $1.49 with any pizza purchase. And when you buy the video at your local video store, you get the Pizza Hut value card for great pizza value. So experience the fantasy of Beauty and the Beast, now with Pizza Hut.
Sears early opening sale, tomorrow, Saturday, 8 to 10 a.m. Save 10% on all regular priced appliances and electronics. Plus, knock an extra 10% off regular and sale merchandise in all other departments. Tomorrow, Saturday, 8 to 10 a.m. at Sears.
Today they ran my legs off.
I thought my knees would buckle.
I think this helped. I felt these little things, these wonderful little of energy spurring me on.
They feel like lead.
Legs Sheer Energy Pantyhose. You got it,
oh,
or you don't.
I'm wearing them tomorrow.
Make dentist appointment. Oh, get brakes checked.
Rick, what are you doing?
Covering myself. I've had this feeling lately, overwhelming, that there's something I'm not taking care of. I wake up every morning with my chest pounding.
Let's have a look.
Dispose of Dorfman's body.
Rick, what's this all about?
Oh, my dream about school. I looked it up. It's classic anxiety. It means that I'm spread so thin, I'm juggling so many things, that I'm panicked I've let something drop. Like, wait, is it you? Are you getting everything you need? Food, guidance? Do you know where babies come from?
Ricky.
All right, okay. Oh, you have a track meet today, remember? Right, okay, you're fine. What is it then? Library books, staff meeting in 5 minutes. Oh, God! I gotta call the hospital, tell them I'm on my way. See, I almost forgot, but my list helps me to keep from losing track of things. Where's the phone?
All right, nobody move. Who stole my math homework?
The math burglar was on his way out when I came in.
I don't believe this. I spent 15 minutes on that homework.
Oh, there's no use. There's no way I can read this whole book and do a book report by tomorrow.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Hey, you two ever read Lord of the Flies?
Brody!
Not again.
You didn't forget to read another book, did you?
No, I read it. Most of it.
Really? How did you like the character of the sassy, back-talking waitress, Flo?
Waitress? I thought it was about an island.
Thousand Island. It was her favorite dressing.
Boy,
Flo was like a major character.
Right. She was like the best part of the book.
Oh. Wait, Flo, of course. Waitress, Heart of Gold.
Write this. Lord of the Flies is the heartwarming story of a big city garbage collector.
Please, that much I know.
Okay, they can hold up the meeting for me, but now I need somebody to watch Sophie. Brody? Oh, track meet, right.
Ricky?
How about you girls?
Sorry, I'm helping at a poetry reading.
Ooh, Ricky, I'm moody today. I don't know if I'd trust me with anything small and fragile.
I understand. Who can I get?
Ricky?
You know, Melissa's 13. Maybe she's mature enough to babysit.
Ricky, you drew all of my math homework when you were on the phone. God, why do you always have to destroy everything good?
Okay, Dorfman.
Oh, yes, you'll be proud. I won't make you sorry.
I'll be proud if you don't make the evening news. All right, I'm going. There is something. Sophie, track meet, staff meeting.
Everything's fine, Rick. Go.
All right, I'm going. Oh, have you applied to college?
Go!
Beauty, you mean you love me even though I am a beast? Beauty.
I'm thinking.
Okay, new game.
Let's play Gone with the Wind again. I'll be Scarlet.
Okay, well, you were Scarlet last time. Let me be Scarlet and you can be General Sherman.
Okay, and Morty can be Rhett.
Okay, who can be Rhett?
Morty.
Right, right. And Morty is?
Rhett.
I mean, who is he?
Scarlet's boyfriend.
Cut it out. Who's Morty?
This is Morty. He's my friend.
Oh, I get it. Hi, Morty.
Do you have a friend like Morty?
Well, I'm not sure. Sometimes I'm stalked by a gorilla named Fancy. Nah, we don't have to get into it, though.
Good, let's play.
Okay, good.
Oh, General Sherman, please don't burn down Atlanta. My whole family has lived here for generations, profiting nicely off the blood and sweat of those less fortunate than ourselves.
Morty, help! Morty, help! Morty? Where is he? Oh, no, the front door's open.
Oh, no. What's that mean?
Morty ran away.
No, he didn't. He's right here. Say hi, Morty.
Dorfman, that's a pillow. Morty's not here. Someone left the door open.
Where you going? Oh, come on, Sophie. I'll find Morty, I promise. Oh, great. I lost Morty. Oh, Brody, thank God you're home. I've done a terrible, terrible thing.
What? What is it? Where's Sophie?
Sit down.
Dorfman, I don't like the sound of this.
When I was babysitting Sophie... Morty ran away.
Morty?
Ran away.
Morty?
Ran away.
Stop saying that! Who's Morty?
Sophie's an invisible friend. We were playing and he ran away.
Well, how do you know he ran away?
Well, come on, do you see him here?
He's invisible.
So you have met him.
Dorfman, just calm down.
I can't calm down. Ricky trusted me and I let her down. I'm gonna find Morty before she gets back. She'll never trust me again.
Find Morty? What are you gonna do? Go around the neighborhood tacking up blank pieces of paper?
Good idea. Morty's run away before, hasn't he?
Dorfman, can you not be insane for like 5 minutes? If you don't want Ricky to know, don't tell her.
That's lying. I can't lie. I'm no good at it. Okay, but not to Ricky. I can never live with myself.
Hi. How'd it go?
Fine.
Great. I'm sorry I doubted you. I should have known you'd come through for me.
Oh, yeah.
Rick, Gary Jensen and I are going to study in the bedroom tonight with the door closed, okay?
No.
What? Why not?
Four reasons. Bedroom, night, door closed.
God, it's like a prison camp around here. No wonder Morty ran away.
Gross.
Get a Kleenex or something.
Wait, who's Morty? I thought we were talking about Gary.
Morty, Sophie's imaginary friend. She just told me he ran away.
Sophie has an imaginary friend?
Well, not anymore. God, you never listen to me, ever.
How was your staff meeting?
What's going on?
No, okay, I confess. I lost your little girl's most precious friend. Yeah, that's right, me, Dorfman, ender of innocence, killer of childhood.
Huh. It's Sophie.
No, it's Dorfman. Melissa's right. She's not a listener.
No, it's Sophie. I'm not taking care of. She must be making up imaginary friends because I'm not around enough.
Oh, no, Rick, you're around plenty.
Well, not for my taste.
Well, but if an imaginary friend is bad, what does it mean that he ran away?
Maybe it signals the death of her inner child.
Maybe her inner child is now her outer child, which means all her organs would be on the outside.
Obviously, something is bothering her. Maybe I should talk to someone.
professional.
You know anyone at the hospital?
Yeah, but I don't know if they're up to handling anything this weird. Dorfman, who does your mother go to? Dr. Shirley?
Oh, you must be Ricky.
I'm sorry I'm late. I took the wrong exit and had to take surface streets the whole way.
Aren't you brave? You did a scary thing and you should be proud.
No.
Come on. I did a scary thing.
Honestly, though, it was nothing.
And
I'm proud.
Good for you. So, what brings you here, Ricky?
Well, I'm here about my little girl.
She's frightened, and she's inside all of us. Even Dr. Shirley.
No, I'm really here about my little girl, my six-year-old Sophie.
Good for you for making things clear.
Well, the problem is, she has an invisible friend.
Oh, neat. Oh.
Not really. I mean, I know that's a serious thing.
Oh, no. An invisible friend is a wonderful, healthy expression of a creative mind.
Well, a fat lot of good that does me.
What?
It's just... my life these days is just... like this toy. It's like spring-loaded with all these parts. The Brody part, the Melissa part, the job part. And I just know there's this one part in here. If I pull it out, the whole thing...
Oh,
sorry!
I hate that.
Me too. I hate not knowing what part is about to pull loose, but... now I know that it's the Sophie part, and I think I've caught it in time. I just need to know what to do.
Nothing.
No, you don't understand.
An invisible friend is good. Your daughter is fine.
She's not fine, though. I'm not around enough. I accept that.
It's not about you. Sophie is playing creatively.
I don't think so.
Yes, she's expressing a boundless imagination.
She's feeling depressed and abandoned.
She's bright.
She's neurotic.
Creative.
Lonely.
Okay, you're right. You feel better now, Nurse Wilder?
Hey, if you want to believe that a little girl would just make up an imaginary friend for no reason, go right ahead, Dr. Shirley.
Well, you know so much. Why don't you be the doctor, and I'll be the incompetent mom?
No, I could never be the doctor. I don't know how to work the sandbox.
I don't know how to work the sandbox.
Oh, that's mature. Fine. You win. Sophie's great. She just made up an invisible friend and had him run away because she's happy as a clam.
Wait, he ran away?
Yes.
Oh, why didn't you tell me this first? This is not good.
Aha! I was right. My child is seriously disturbed. Ha!
We all count on our batteries to get us through, but you never know when they're going to hit the skids. Only Duracell has the copper top battery tester, so you can be sure your batteries will keep you gliding along. You can't top the copper top.
Son, what do you think of when you think of Florida? Florida orange juice and me, right?
No, just Florida orange juice.
Oh, well, I'm going to be the official spokesman for Florida orange juice, and I'm perfect for it.
I think I'm perfect for it. It's full of vitamin C and minerals. There's pure, natural, get up and go in every glass. 100% pure Florida orange juice will get you on your feet.
That's my line. Just be cute.
Okay, go ahead and try it.
100% pure Florida orange juice. Get you on your feet.
Trust me, Dad. I'll sell it. You do the cute part.
Life is just a bowl of cherries.
Today, women need all the comfort and support they can get. No wonder Playtex are the bras they love to live in.
Live and laugh at it all.
Let's not unpack.
Do it tomorrow. I wish we were still in Vienna.
Me too. Here, this'll take you back.
Chocolate. This reminds me of the coffee that we had that night.
New Viennese Chocolate Cafe. Rich coffee with a touch of luscious chocolate.
That was my favorite night in Vienna.
But we never went out.
Celebrate the moment.
New from General Foods International Coffees.
Parents love to tell about when they were kids. It's called nostalgia.
I had a Tonka truck.
A mini Cabbage Patch Kid. I always loved dolls.
A McDonald's hamburger Happy Meal will give you that nostalgic feeling. For just $1.99, you can get a mini Cabbage Patch Kid.
Cute hair.
Or a mini Tonka truck with parts that move. One toy with every Happy Meal you buy your kids. Plus, get coupons and rebates for up to $50 off name brand toys and games.
What you want is what you get. And McDonald's today.
The man who killed John Lennon, for the first time ever, he tells me why.
I heard this voice saying, do it, do it, do it, do it.
Watch 2020, next.
Thursday, it's country music's biggest night. Join your hosts Clint Black and Mary Chapin Carpenter as we count down this year's best. It's country music like you've never seen it, featuring performances by your favorite artists. The Best of Country 92, Thursday.
There's really a big family reunion in Lord of the Flies?
Sure, that's where Flo wins the big chili cook-off. Using her famous recipe for roasted wild pig.
Roasted wild pig. Come on, you guys. Is that really important?
Brody, you're so dense. The pig is the symbol for what the whole book is about.
It is?
What do pigs eat?
Garbage.
What's the story about?
A garbage collector. Oh, God, this is great. Teachers love it when you tie stuff in.
Honey, we have to talk about Morty.
Morty's gone.
I know, and it's okay that you're angry. I know I've been preoccupied lately and haven't been around as much as you need.
Yes, you have.
No, I haven't. Why do you think Morty ran away?
I don't know. Because the door is open?
Morty ran away because you're afraid Mommy will abandon you.
Will you?
No.
Okay.
But just so that you know that, I'm making special time for us. I'm going to read to you. Doesn't that sound like fun?
I was going to call her.
No, honey, no. We're spending special time together. I'm going to read to you from this great Dick and Jane book that Grandma used to read to me.
I really want to.
Sally sets the table. It's Sally's turn to set the table.
Is this a long book?
No, it's short. She has to set places for everyone. She sets one place down for Mommy, Daddy, Dick, and Jane.
Does the book have ducks?
Sophie.
Morty! Sophie! Look! Look, I found Morty!
Man, Morty's imaginary.
Yeah?
He's real. I told you.
You're slipping in and out again, aren't you?
I took a shot. Come on, I know what's real and what's not. Please let that be Morty.
Hello? Yes, it is. Mr. Hasselman. Yes, of course, right away. Thank you. Goodbye. That was Melissa's counselor. He thinks she has a serious problem. I can be so stupid. It must be Melissa I've been neglecting, not Sophie.
Mommy, can we finish the book?
Not now, sweetie.
Sit, sit, sit. Okay, let's just get to the bottom of this. Why won't you take showers?
I beg your pardon?
In gym class, what's the deal?
I was insecure about my body. I didn't know you could still call people in about stuff like that. That was 15 years ago.
Ah, I'm sorry. I thought you were somebody else. And and you are?
Ricky Wilder, I'm here about Melissa.
Right, yeah, I wanted to speak to you about your daughter.
Well, my daughter's fine.
Well, why don't we just let the professionals decide that, all right?
I did, I saw a psychiatrist.
I see, and you think psychiatrists know everything.
No, I mean, wait a minute, do you think that I'm Melissa's mother?
You don't know if you were Melissa's mother?
No, I do know, I'm her sister.
I say, now, does Melissa know that you are not her mother?
She's mentioned it, yes.
Darn, I thought we were on to something there.
Mr. Hasselman, let me just shortcut this for you. The problem is me. You see, I've been so busy lately trying to cover all the bases that I think I've been neglecting Melissa. I hope we caught it in time. She's basically okay, isn't she?
Okay? No, Miss Wilder, Melissa is far from being okay. Unless, of course, you consider that it's okay to be sexually disturbed.
Sexually disturbed? She's 13 years old.
That's exactly why I called you in when I saw the evidence.
What evidence?
Her math teacher saw it first, and she brought it to my attention. Of course, I am no psychiatrist, but I do keep up. You know, I read a lot of books. I have a lot of books.
Mr. Hasselman, what evidence?
They're drawings. Doodles, really. Strange, inappropriate images. Here, they're on the back of her math homework.
Mr. Hasselman, these are mine. I did these drawings.
You're sexually disturbed?
No.
Really, I mean, this fire hose is clearly an image of...
Cleansing. The hose is an image of cleansing. I was hoping it was Melissa.
That was disturbed.
Well, the anxiety I'm feeling, the source. I don't know. Maybe I'm just crazy.
But you're not sexually disturbed.
No, Mr. Hasselman, I am not sexually disturbed.
Are you busy Friday night?
A D! You guys got me a D!
How is that possible?
How is that possible? Well, for one thing, Lord of the Flies is not about some garbage collector named Mickey Newlick.
No? Maybe he was just in the movie version.
I had to give an oral report. I stood in front of 30 students and told them that the classic novel about society's atavistic nature was a heartwarming story of garbage collecting. Do you know how I looked?
Ill-informed, unprepared, irresponsible, really, really dumb.
How could you sabotage me like that?
You sabotage yourself, Brody. I resent being used as your personal cliff notes.
Yeah, we're sick of it. You just love us for our minds.
You know what? I don't like you guys. Oh, I am really mad at those guys. Really, really mad at those guys.
Brody.
I'm not talking to you.
I just want to say one thing. How did you get a D? What did you get right?
I guess she was impressed, by the way. Flo killed the Lord of the Flies with her no pest strip.
Is she gonna let you make it up?
Yes, but I have to read Farewell to Arms.
Oh, the tragic tale of a nearsighted farmer and his threshing machine.
Mommy, are you sad?
I guess I am a little.
Do you want to read me the book? You seem to like that.
Sure, honey. Here. Sit down. Okay. Where were we? Okay. It's Sally's turn to set the table. She has to set places for everyone. She sets one place down for Mommy, Daddy, Dick, and Jane. Then Sally counts. 1, 2, 3, 4 places. What's wrong, Sally thinks. There's one place missing. So Sally counts. Mommy, Daddy, Dick, and Jane. That's everyone. Sally counts again. 1, 2, 3, 4 places. One place missing. Sophie, Sally only said 4 places. She forgot someone.
I got that part already.
Sally forgot herself. There's a place for everyone but Sally.
Sally's kind of dumb.
No, honey, it's just that Sally has so many people that she loves and takes care of that she forgot to take care of herself.
Is that how it ends?
Fortunately, no.
You bears come in?
Thank you, honey. Oh, you go play now, okay? Mommy has someone else she needs to spend some time with.
I bet bears come in.
Thank you. You mean too little.
The best for me, try Minix Little Cup.
Dosages by weight.
And by age. So simple.
Give us your worst, we'll give you our best. Improve Tri-Minic with the all-new True Dose System.
Smart.
Sears early opening sale. Tomorrow, Saturday, 8 to 10 a.m. Save 10% on all regular priced appliances and electronics. Plus, knock an extra 10% off regular and sale merchandise in all other departments. Tomorrow, Saturday, 8 to 10 a.m. at Sears.
Parents love to tell about when they were kids. It's called nostalgia.
I had a Tonka truck.
A mini Cabbage Patch Kid. I always loved dolls.
A McDonald's Hamburger Happy Meal will give you that nostalgic feeling. For just $1.99, you can get a mini Cabbage Patch Kid.
Cute hair.
Or a mini Tonka truck with parts that move. One toy with every Happy Meal you buy your kids. Plus, get coupons and rebates for up to $50 off name brand toys and games.
What you want is what you get. And McDonald's today.
Tuesday, Jackie's throwing a bash for charity.
Save our universe now.
And I thought it was an ego thing.
TV Guide calls it a hit.
Jackie, it's Paul Newman. Tell him to bring some popcorn and salad dressing.
The Jackie Thomas Show.
While you're in the H's, call Geraldo.
Tuesday after Roseanne.
Well, that's it for another TGIF. But before we go, people have been wanting to know how big our set is. Well, our set is actually an infinite universe within itself. Finish traveling, that ball will land right there about now. Okay, the set's like 20 feet by 30 feet. See you later.
One while you must.